Thank you. And now, once again, ladies and gentlemen, Kriya Caping.
There on the kiss list are the big relationship hitters, right? There's the Babe Ruth of love. He's pointing out to, no, left field for a big home run of romance. There's the Joe DiMaggio of heartbreak, and he's there with a slugging percentage of pain you never thought you could feel like that much. On my big relationship kisses on the list, there's my college boyfriend. You know, we were there and on his mattress, which this is college, so obviously it's a mattress on the floor. And I, for the very first time, told someone that I loved them. And so we smoked our cigarettes and we thought about how we would escape to Prague and live there forevermore. And there on the big relationship hitter kiss list is the man who broke my heart over pancakes. No, it was waffles. And he's taking up a big space that is probably more deserving of a better chap. But still on the kiss list is there's room for the small hitters. They make the cut because they were there before anything else because of unbelievable circumstance and outrageous situations. So my grandmother and I went to Europe together as a high school, end of high school graduation gift. And we went on Globus International Tour, and our first stop was Spain. Now, Spain had filled my vision for so long with thoughts of passion and romance and sounds of flamenco music. And flamenco is the embodiment of romance. This was invented by a passionate people, and with every pulsing palma, it was love, romance, desire. And so I went to Salamanca, Spain. And so often happens in the space between imagination and reality, my trip was less of a bodice-inducing adventure and more of a retiree's bus tour. I was the only person on the bus tour that couldn't use their AARP discount at the hotel. I was their under 50 mascot. And so I got so fed up at one point that I hid in the Prado Museum and wouldn't leave to get back on the bus. And that's when my grandmother realized that maybe I needed to spend some time with peers of my own age. And so when we got to Salamanca, she said, why don't you go off and have an adventure this afternoon? And we'll stay for our scheduled afternoon nap. And I was like, oh my God, here it is, this vision I had had of Spain. And so I went off to the plaza. And I was there in the plaza, and I was looking around for where my destiny might be. And there I saw some cafe tables with red tablecloths. And I thought, there's the sign, the sign. And so it was like, you know, the red of a corazón, the red of the fleur under the flamenco skirt. And so that is where I would do my international woman of mystery. I would sit there as soon as I could unhook myself from my travel purse that was for safety's sake, you know, under like five layers. And so I'm trying to take my shirt and kind of get out so it's tangled up in my bra. And I'm squirming around and I look like a dog chasing its tail. And I will be sexy as soon as I can get myself unhinged. And that's when someone grabs my arm. And I turn to a steel wall of abs. And I look up into literally the most beautiful Latin face I had ever seen in my life. I mean, he was my same age, but he had this old world look to him, like he was a conquistador. And as soon as I could get my arm unhinged, I would raise him in submission and give myself to him. And he said, what would you like? And I thought, oh, I want you. I still had the giggles all these years later. Oh, yes. But words were not on the outside, and he was still waiting to hear. And I said, I couldn't think of English or Spanish, and so I just sounded like a Buddhist monk. So he was trying to be helpful. Un bebida? A drink? Yes. Kriya, pull yourself together for God's sake. Here is a man with the longest lashes you've ever seen. Bebida. Okay, I was thinking, what could I order? I know. I will have a margarita, por favor. A margarita. Salamanca, Spain was open and established as a city in the 3rd century BC. This was not Cancun, okay? This was a spring break for margarita. I couldn't think of a vino or a sangria, but instead of him turning away in disgust, he leaned forward and he said, "How do you make this margarita?" Well, here was my opportunity to redeem myself. And not be naive, I was going to put on the International Woman of Mystery. Margarita. Well, the only drink I had ever made was just holding out a paper cup as someone poured some beer in it. I was still underage. So, yes, it is tequila. It is some ice, I said. A lime. What else do you put in a margarita? To this day, I don't know. And some salt around the rim. Well, he went off in a flourish, and soon he was back like a matador with my drink in front of a thirsty bull. Here is your margarita. Oh, yes, thank you. Well, there it was, my margarita in a tumbler, and it had one rock of salt, or one rock of ice. It had about this much tequila. It had a lime, and it had 2 inches worth of salt at the bottom. Oh, yes. But there was this God-blessed face, and he was waiting for me to drink my Spanish margarita. And so I couldn't disappoint him. So I thought if I tilted it enough so the salt, like, you know, a sand dune didn't fall down, I could drink the tequila and save the salt from going. So in a very sexy way, I was like, ooh. And so I drank it, and as you know, one rock started the avalanche into my mouth, and all the salt went down. And for a brief moment, there was ringing in my ear, and I had one eye open, and I was like, delicioso. And he was like, oh. Can I make you another? And I was like, no. What do I owe you? I will just pay. And this is when it was like a page ripped from a Harlequin romance novel. He said, the price is 1 peso. It was 1 kiss I was to give him. And it was great because my lips were still puckered from all the salt. And I was like, okay. And I kissed him, ladies and gentlemen. I kissed him long, and I kissed him hard. And I remembered my 4 steps. I leaned in. I closed my eyes. This time I knew you could breathe through your nose, and I was breathing. And I went for it. Oh, yes. I know, I'm making myself hot right now. And I went for it. And as I pulled away, I could see his face, and there was just shock. He was like, it was like he drank all of the ocean. He was like. And that's when I realized all these years later, my kisses were still tasting a lot like salt. And the kisses since have been salty, and they have been sweet, and some of them have left sour memories. But there on my kiss list is always a room on the top 10 for the kiss of my future, the smooch that will always come.